Thank you for introduction. Good afternoon. My name is Kei Hiroi. I talk about accurate and early detection of localized heavy rain by integrating multi-vendor sensors in various installation environments. Localized heavy rain have been recently increasing due to the effect of global warming. Localized heavy rain leads to flash floods, and flash floods cause heavy damage. An accurate and early prediction of localized heavy rain is significantly required to warn people. People need a localized heavy rain forecast at least 60 minutes prior to the occurrence. However, the existing meteorological technologies can only detect the initiation of localized heavy rain 30 minutes prior to the occurrence. Traditional sensors are insufficient for the prediction of localized heavy rain. If we measure rainfall throughout a city, sensors need to be placed in as many locations as possible. It means highly dense sensor networks. However, they are only placed at every 17 kilometers in Japan. We consider how to predict by utilizing a surface meteorological monitoring networks. Next, I will explain how to detect localized heavy rain by using surface meteorological monitoring networks. It uses various sensors and it can detect convection that initiates the formation of cumulonimbus clouds based on wind convergence. This figure shows how clouds are created. Warm air near the ground surface and cold winds blow from sea to land, and they create cumulonimbus clouds. Monitoring convection can detect the existence of clouds faster than traditional observations. So we decided to use surface meteorological monitoring networks. Our approach monitors wind convergence from wind speed and wind direction data. Numerous sensors measure this data. However, to detect convection, we have two problems. The first problem is difficulty in producing an accurate and early prediction. Local governments and meteorological organizations independently construct sensors. Therefore, sensor development causes information with different data formats and units because of different vendors. Second problem is various installation environments. Sensors are placed in different installation environments. So raw data are significantly different depending on environment. I'd like to emphasize this difference because of multi-vendor and various installation environments. So we attempt to calibrate the differences in sensor data caused by the different vendor and the different installation environment. We propose three functions for prediction. In this next few minutes, I'd like to explain these three functions. First function is integrating multi-vendor sensors. Our system can translate various raw data to a common format. First, we collect wind speed and wind direction data. Next, the communication protocol integrates data. For instance, the directional notation of the wind can be provided in degrees or its cardinal direction. Our system integrates its difference. Second function is calibrating sensor data. Calibration is important for our research, and our calibration includes two schemes. First scheme is for altitude. Wind speed depends on the altitude of the sensor and the presence of surrounding buildings. We calibrate wind speed for all sensors as if they are placed at the same altitude. Calibrated wind speed is calculated by multiplying wind speed by the rate of altitude. Second scheme is for the sky view factor. The sky view factor indicates the relationship between the visible area of the sky and the area covered by buildings. Wind speed is calculated as if the sky view factor is 100% based on the relationship between the wind speed and the sky view factor. Third function is accurate and early prediction of localized heavy rain. We calculate the vertical component and horizontal component of the wind direction by using the collected sensor data. These components calculate the convergence rate by the following equation. If convergence rate is less than minus 1 point, it indicates convection. So I explained our proposal with three functions: integration, calibration, and prediction. So we implement the localized heavy rain prediction system and evaluate its effectiveness. We collected wind speed and wind direction by 65 sensors. They are placed approximately 2 km apart. Proposed system calculated the convergence rate of the wind by using our calibration scheme. We compared convergence rates with the actual time of rainfall. This figure shows evaluation results. Black line shows low sensor data value, and dot line indicates calibrated data. We observe peak rainfall at 15:10, and the convergence became minus point at 1 at 1440 of low sensor data. So low sensor data detects the initiation of localized heavy rain at 1440, and calibrated data detects the initiation of localized heavy rain 4010. So the Surface Meteorological Monitoring Networks used road sensor data detects localized heavy rain 30 minutes earlier than the actual occurrence of the localized heavy rain. On the other hand, our scheme surface meteorological monitoring networks that use calibrated data could observe and detect, could detect localized heavy rain 30 minutes earlier than that without the calibration. As a result, our system detects localized heavy rain earlier than existing schemes. Calibrated scheme can detect localized heavy rain 60 minutes prior to the occurrence. People can evacuate safely in 60 minutes in Japan. So proposed calibration scheme contributes to the early detection of localized heavy rain. This is my conclusion. We proposed a novel system that produced accurate and early localized heavy rain predictions. We have two problems, different vendors and different installation environments of surface meteorological monitoring networks. They cause difficulties in producing an accurate and early prediction because surface meteorological monitoring network uses numerous sensors in various installation environments. We implemented the novel system with a calibration scheme so we could detect localized heavy rain earlier than existing observations, and the proposed system is effective for the early detection. That's all my presentation. Thank you for listening.